Hello viewers, in this lecture, let us discuss a quick review on the structure of autumn topic, most important points and some major formulae which we use in this topic. We discuss in this video, very very important, this is very useful for the revision before the exams. Okay, so here the first one is charge to mass ratio, or this is also called specific charge of electron, is equal, that is given by E by ME. This is the charge of electron and this is the mass of electron, that is equal to 1.75820 into 10 power 11 coulomb kilogram inverse. So generally we can take it as 1.76 into 10 power 11 also. Okay, here next, mass of moving electron is equal to M, that is denoted by M, is equal to rest mass of electron M0 by square root of 1 minus V by C whole square. This is also one of the very important formula. Okay, mass of the moving electron can be calculated by using this relation. See here, V is the velocity of electron and C is the velocity of light. Okay, clear? Suppose here, when V is equal to C, then what happens? This will be 1, 1 minus 1, 0. So something by 0, that is infinite. So when velocity of electron is equal to the velocity of light, then mass of moving electron is infinite. Okay, important point to note here, this one. Next, E by M value of ions with respect to hydrogen atom, okay, is equal to magnitude of charge or relative charge with respect to hydrogen atom by mass number or relative mass number. Okay, so this is, we can, by using this formula, we can calculate charge to mass ratio of any ion with respect to hydrogen atom. Very important, this one also. See here, suppose we have a small question here. What is the E by M value of helium plus 2 ion with respect to hydrogen atom? Okay, so here how can we calculate E by M value of helium plus 2 is equal to magnitude of charge. What is the charge present here? Plus 2. Okay, so magnitude, only magnitude we have to take, no need to take the sign whether that is positive or negative. So that's why simply we are writing magnitude of charge, right? 2 by mass number. Okay, so helium 2, helium 4, yes or no? This is the atomic number, this is the mass number, which we know that. Okay, so 2 by 4 mass number or relative mass number with respect to hydrogen, that is equal to 1 by 2, so that is nothing but 0.5. okay, charge to mass ratio of helium plus 2 ion with respect to hydrogen atom is how much? 0.5. okay, clear? So in this way, direct questions we get, so this is important formula, just substitute here. Okay, next, In the Mulliker oil drop experiment, the magnitude of charge on the oil drop, that is denoted by Q, Q is equal to N into E. Okay, the Mulliker oil drop experiment, the charge present on the oil drop equal to Q equal to N into E. So here N is equal to any integer, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever it may be. And E is the charge of electron, that is equal to, we know that, 1.6022 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. See, next here, the Planck's quantum theory related equations. So here, the energy of photon emitted or absorbed is directly proportional to the frequency. Okay, so here E is, if we remove this proportionality, we get a constant, that is E equal to h nu. This is also one of the most important relation in science. Okay, where this h is a Planck's constant, its value is 6.626 into 10 power minus 34 joule second, or 6.626 into 10 power minus 27 erg second. See here, it is not joule per second, joule second. Okay, same here also, erg second, not erg per second. Remember that you must be very careful. Okay, this is a simple relation, but in the problem, this is sometimes many students will get confusion. No need to confuse. E equal to h nu, this is the energy of one photon. Suppose if total amount of energy emitted or absorbed by n number of photons, more than one photon is there, then E equal to nh nu. This is the general formula. So n may be 1, 2, 3, 4. N equal to 1, energy of one photon. N equal to 2, we get 2 h nu, like that. Okay. So this is the formula used to calculate energy of n number of photons, that may be absorbed energy or emitted energy. Next, energy of one mole of photons, that is equal to E equal to n into h nu. This n is Avogadro's number. Okay, so Avogadro number is, this is the 6.023 into 10 power 23. Okay, so for one mole of photons, this is the formula. For n number of photons, this is the formula. For one photon, E equal to h nu. These three very, very important. Okay, don't get any confusion. For one mole means E equal to n into h nu. Okay, and Einstein related this one as E equal to h nu. But nu is equal to c by lambda. If you substitute this relation here, we get E equal to hc by lambda. Okay. See, in detail, we discuss all these concepts for revision purpose. I am first explaining all the formulas here. Okay. So, E equal to hc by lambda. Okay. Einstein stated that the emitted radiation propagated in the form of waves. So, that's why he gave this relation like this. E equal to hc by lambda. This is the wavelength of the waves, electromagnetic radiation, which is propagating. And also here another important relation, nu bar, that is a wave number, is equal to 1 by lambda. If you substitute this one here, we get E equal to hc nu bar, another important relation. Okay, so E equal to hc nu bar. See, depending upon the information provided in the problem, we have to use the suitable formula. Next here, the major relations are two key points in the photoelectric effect is that the number of photoelectrons ejected is directly proportional to the intensity or brightness of the incident light. Incident light means the light which is falling on the metal surface. Okay, number of photons ejected directly proportional to intensity. And kinetic energy of the photoelectrons. Photoelectrons, what is photoelectron? The electrons which are ejected in the photoelectric effect. Okay, so kinetic energy is directly proportional to the frequency of incident light. Okay, very, very important. Number of photons depends on the intensity. Kinetic energy depends on the frequency of the incident light. Okay, very, very important points. And next, see here, h nu, total energy equal to work function plus kinetic energy. This so phi is work function. Okay. We know that what is the phi, the minimum energy required to eject the electron from the metal surface is work function. Okay, so here work function phi equal to h nu naught. If you substitute here, we get h nu equal to h nu naught plus ke. See here, this frequency is the threshold frequency. Okay, and nu means the frequency of the incident light. This is the frequency of the light falling on the metal surface. And this is the minimum frequency which is required to remove, eject the electron from the metal surface. And also h nu equal to h nu naught plus half me v square. We know that kinetic energy equal to half me v square. It is me is the mass of electron, that we know. And v is the velocity associated with ejected electron. Okay. The ejected electron has some velocity. This v is the velocity of that ejected electron. Next, from this relation, if you rearrange this, we get kinetic energy equal to h of nu minus nu naught. Okay, direct questions were asked many times, very, very important. And also, suppose if frequencies are given, this relation we use. If wavelengths are given, then kinetic energy equal to hc into 1 by lambda minus 1 by lambda naught. Because we know that nu equal to c by lambda. And nu naught equal to c by lambda naught. C is the velocity of light, that is constant. Okay, so lambda is the wavelength of the incident light. Lambda naught is the wavelength, that is the threshold wavelength. Okay, so if frequencies are given, use this relation to calculate kinetic energy. If wavelengths are given, use this relation to calculate kinetic energy. And one important key point here is that if nu equal to nu naught, then kinetic energy equal to zero. Yes or no? If nu equal to nu naught, that is the incident light frequency equal to threshold frequency, then the kinetic energy of ejected electron is zero. Next, from the Bohr's model of atom, key points and formulas, the frequency of radiation absorbed or emitted when transition occurs between two stationary states. Sir, electron may jump from lower energy level to higher energy level by absorbing energy, or electron when coming from higher to lower level, that will emit the energy. Okay, and the frequency associated with that radiation equal to nu is equal to delta E by H, that is equal to E2 minus E1 by H. Delta E is E2 minus E1, the energy difference between two states. So here E1 and E2 are the energies of lower and higher allowed energy states. Okay, so this is called as Bohr's frequency rule. Okay, Bohr's frequency rule. Next, Bohr's condition for the angular momentum is MeVr equal to n into h by 2 pi. Okay, so this is the Bohr's angular momentum condition. So here, what is Me, mass of electron, which we discussed many times. V is the linear velocity and R is the radius of the orbit in which electron is revolving. N is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. This H is Planck's constant, that we know that. Okay, next. The centripetal force of attraction between the electron and nucleus is equal to minus ze square by r square. Direct questions are asked in the previous cases in various competitive exams. Next, centrifugal force. So, see, this is a centripetal force minus ze square by r square. Next, centrifugal force of the electron due to the revolving around the nucleus is equal to minus mv square by r. Okay, minus mv square by r. Okay, so these are the some important relation. Next, we discuss the radius expression, energy, velocity. Next, here radius expression. The radius of nth orbit rn equal to n square h square by 4 pi square e square z into m. See, here n is the orbit number 1, 2, 3, 4 and H is the Planck's constant, that is the value, we know that. And 4, pi, these two are, this is a number, this is also a constant. E is the charge of electron, that is the value, already we discussed. And Z is atomic number and M is mass of the electron, that is the mass of the electron. Okay, so if you substitute all these constants and simplification, we get Rn equal to 0.529 into n square by z angstrom. Very, very important relation this one. Okay, many times direct questions were asked. Okay, radius of nth orbit equal to 0.529 into n square by z angstrom. Next, for hydrogen atom, atomic number is equal to 1. Okay, if you substitute here, we get Rn equal to 0.529 into n square angstrom. If you express the radius in picometer, then we get 52.9 into n square picometer, because 1 angstrom equal to 10 power 2 picometers. Okay, in the place of 52.9 picometer, if you write A naught, this is the general expression for hydrogen atom. See, A naught equal to 52.9 picometer. Okay, so this is the radius of first stationary state. This is, that is also called as Bohr's orbit. Okay, so this is the value of radius of the first stationary state. Next, very, very important in the entire structure of atom, that is the expression for energy. We have different expressions. See here, first of all, kinetic energy of electron is equal to half mev square, that is equal to ze square by 2r. Ze square by 2r. Z is the atomic number, it is the charge, and this is the radius. Okay, and potential energy of electron equal to minus ze square by r. Kinetic energy ze square by 2r, potential energy is minus ze square by r. And total energy of the electron is nothing but kinetic energy plus potential energy, that we get minus ze square by 2r. Okay, so you should be very careful here. Okay, next. The ratio of kinetic energy, potential energy and total energy is 1:-2:-1. This is asked in the various entrance examinations in the previous cases. Direct question. Okay. And next, energy of electron in the nth orbit generalized expression is E of En equal to -2π² mz² e^4 / n² h² Okay, see here, the z and n are the variables, remaining all are constants. By substituting all the constants and after simplification we get En equal to -2.18 × 10⁻¹⁸ joules per atom by n square. Okay, so this is for a hydrogen atom we are discussing, because z equal to 1 for the hydrogen atom, right? Okay, so for a hydrogen like species we get in this way. See, this is for the hydrogen atom and this is for hydrogen atom like species. Helium plus lithium plus 2 or beryllium plus 3, that we get En equal to -2.18 × 10⁻¹⁸ z² / n² For hydrogen, Z is 1, so that's why we are not writing here. Okay, next here, this can be written in the simple way like this also. En equal to -Ah/n² or -Rh/n² Here, Ah or Rh is equal to (2.18 × 10⁻¹⁸ joules per atom. Okay, next, suppose if you want to express in terms of erg, then we get 2.18 × 10⁻¹ⁱ ergs per atom. See, everything is the same because 1 joule equal to 10⁻⁷ erg. Instead of 10⁻¹, here we get 10⁻¹ erg per atom. Or if you want to express in the electron volt, -13.6 electron volt per atom by n square. Because 1 electron volt equal to 1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹ joules. Okay, or see this three expressions, the energy per atom. Next here, the energy per mole. In the examinations, you must be very careful. They may give sometimes per atom and sometimes per mole. Okay, you should be very careful by looking at the units and value we can easily identify. So, -13.12 kilojoule per mole by n square, or -313.6 kilocalorie per mole by n square. Okay, in the joules means we get (10³). In calories means this (10⁴). That is, you know, very simple. Next, this already we discussed. This is for hydrogen atom. This is for hydrogen like species. General expression. See here, next. En equal to -(E₁ × z²/n²). So here, in the place of 2.18 × 10⁻¹⁸ joules, we can write simply E₁. This E₁ is nothing but energy of electron in first orbit of hydrogen atom. Okay, what is E₁? Energy of electron in the first orbit of hydrogen atom. So we can write this one as En equal to -(E₁ × z²/n²). Okay, this is about the energy, different expressions depending upon the units which we are using. The ionization energy, many times questions are asked related to ionization energy also. So ionization energy is equal to -(E₁ × z²/n²), or in the place of E₁ we can write 13.6 electron volt, then we get -13.6 × z²/n² electron volt. Generally, ionization energy is expressed in electron volt. Okay, next, Rydberg's equation. See here, this is the relation used to calculate wave number, that is the reciprocal of wavelength, right? That is equal to (R)(1/N₁²-(1/N₂²)(z²). Z is the atomic number, and energy difference between the two transition between the two energy levels, that is delta E equal to (Rh)(1/N₁²-(1/N₂²)(z²). For a hydrogen atom, Z equal to 1, only this relation. For any other hydrogen like species, Z is not equal to 1, so that's why here we get (Z²). Okay, and another most important thing here is that, see, this is The energy levels arranged in the increasing order of their energy. First energy level, second energy level, third, fourth, fifth, sixth energy level. The most important thing here you should observe is that so many times questions are asked related to this one. As the n value increases, the energy difference between the two successive energy levels decreases. See here, this much energy difference between 1 and 2. And 2 and 3, just little bit of difference when compared to this one. Here very less, very less, very very less. As n value increases, the energy difference between the two successive levels decreases. Means the energy required to jump the electron from here to here is more, and here to here is less energy is enough to jump from 2 to 3 when compared to jumping from 1 to 2. Okay, so more energy is required for the excitation of electron from 1 to 2 than that of 2 to 3 and so on. Next here, if we consider the line spectrum of hydrogen, okay, here just now we discussed that nu bar wave number is equal to 1 by lambda, that is equal to, this is the relation. So here in the place of R, so we can take 109677 centimeter inverse, or we can take 1.09677 meter inverse. See here, 109677 we get in the centimeter inverse, 1.09677 we get in the meter inverse. Okay, next here another very very important one is that wavelength of the limiting line, that is the last line in the series, is given by the formula 1 by lambda infinity equal to, okay, that is nu bar infinity, that is R into Z square into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N infinity square. Okay, see here, in the place of N2 square, we are writing N infinity square. Okay, so suppose, for example, limiting wavelength of Balmer series is obtained by taking N2 is equal to infinity. Okay, in the Balmer series, N1 is equal to 2. So that's why we get 1 by 2 square minus 1 by infinity square, because N2 is, we are assuming it as infinity. So then this is the limiting wavelength in the Balmer series, that is equal to R by 4. Okay, next here, the number of spectral lines obtained in a series we can directly calculate, that is equal to NF minus NI. Okay, and maximum number of spectral lines produced when electron jump from NF to NI state for a simple atom is equal to sigma NF minus NI. This is in a particular series, how many lines we get in Lyman series or in Balmer series, like that. And this one, sigma NF minus NI, total number of lines we get when an electron jump from NF to NI. Okay, so these I will explain with a specific problems in next videos, okay, in which I will explain the problems subtopic wise. Next here, velocity of electron. See, the general expression for the velocity of electron is Vn equal to 2 pi Ze square by NH. Okay, by substituting all the constants and after all simplifications, finally we get Vn equal to 2.188 into 10 power 8 into Z by N centimeters second inverse. Okay, so in the simple way this can be written as Vn equal to V1 into Z by N. Here V1 is equal to 2.188 into 10 power 8 centimeters per second. In the place of this one we have written V1. One major key points here is that the velocity of electron increases when the charge on the nucleus increases. Okay, velocity increases nothing but when Z increases, the velocity of the electron increases. And velocity of electron decreases when the value of N increases. Okay, this is a principal quantum number. If N value increases and then velocity of the electron decreases. Okay, clear? Next, number of revolutions. So for number of revolutions, the formula is velocity by circumference, that is equal to V by 2 pi R. If you substitute the velocity and radius expressions and after simplification, finally we get the formula to calculate number of revolutions made by the electron around the nucleus equal to 6.66 into 10 power 15 into Z square by N cube. Okay, so directly here we have to substitute Z and N, then we get the answer.
Next, time period of revolution. How much time it will take to complete one revolution? That is t equal to 2 pi r by v. Time period of revolution. That is 1.5 into 10 power minus 16 into n cube by z square. If you remember this, no need to separately remember this one. Yes or no? This is just reciprocal of this one. Okay, clear? So next, we discuss, in the another video, we discuss remaining important points and formula in the structure of atom. Thank you and subscribe to our channel.